There's a ship lies rigged ready in the harbor. Tomorrow for England she sails, far away from the land of endless sunshine, to my land full of rainy skies and gales. And I shall be aboard that ship tomorrow, though my heart is full of tears at this farewell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. I heard there's a wicked war a-blazing, and the taste of war I know so very well. Even now I see the foreign flag raising, their guns on fire as we sail into hell. I have no fear of death, it brings no sorrow, but how bitter will be this last farewell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly spoken word can tell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. Through death and darkness gather all about me, and my ship be torn apart upon the seas. I shall smell again the fragrance of these islands, in the heaving waves that brought me once to thee. And should I return safe home again to England, I shall watch the English mist roll through the dell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Anna died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Let us sing together our opening hymn, number 869 in your red ritual song hymn books. Here I am, Lord.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go.
Snow and rain,
I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away.
I will break their hearts of stone,
give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I will hold your people in my heart.
Let us pray. O God, who through the ending of present things open up the beginning of things to come, grant, we pray, that the soul of your servant may be led to you to attain the inheritance of eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Please be seated as we listen to the word of God, and I would like to invite Chase forward for our first reading.
A reading from the book of the Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to give birth and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sew, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. The word of the Lord.
My shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
To invite Matt Ford for our next reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who are baptized into Christ, Jesus, were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in a newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple there whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I thirst." There was a vessel filled with common wine, so they put a sponge soaked in wine on a sprig of hyssop and put it up to his mouth. When Jesus had taken the wine, he said, "It is finished." And bowing his head, he handed over the Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. So I do have to admit, I did not have the joy of knowing Anna in life, but I know her legacy. I know her children, I know her grandchildren. And I've spent a lot of time praying with her in the last couple weeks, especially as we've been preparing for Holy Week and Easter. She's been part of my prayer as we've been entering into these sacred days in the life of the church. One of the things I've come to know about her, even in prayer, is that she very much embodied just the true spirit in a very fierce way of what it means to be a woman and a mother. And you can see that spirit in her children and her grandchildren. And it's a spirit that was given to us to watch over us in a way when Jesus said, "Behold your mother." Jesus knew that it was necessary in order to have this human experience that he shared with us, that the importance of what it means to have a mother. That's not just something that is by coincidence, but in God's divine plan. You see, before Jesus created the stars in the sky and the trees and the mountains and everything that we hold to be good and beautiful and true in this world, Anna was on God's mind, a very real, particular, and unique way. So were you, her loving husband, daughters, children, grandchildren, friends, neighbors, each and every one of us. We're on God's mind in a very real, particular, and unique way. And then when he created humanity in his own image and likeness, and we chose selfishness and brought sin and death into the world, it broke his heart. He said, "That's not good enough for Anna. It's not good enough for you or me. Any one of us." And so he said, "I'm going to fix this." And in the fullness of time, he was born of a woman in that little cave in the town of Bethlehem among sheep and goat and oxen. And as he cried his first cry and took his first breath, he thought of Anna and you and me and each and every one of us. And just like us, he knew what it was like to only know the soothing of a mother's touch, to to know what it was like to fall and skin his knee, to play games and tell jokes, to laugh and tell stories, to have his fill and to go hungry, to know heartache and love. And then when the time came, he stretched out his hands between heaven and earth. And as he hung upon that cross, he thought of Anna and you and me and each and every one of us. And he said, I'm fixing this. And 3 days later, when he opened his eyes to new life, the first person he thought of was Anna and you and me. Very real, particular, and unique way. And there was such joy in his heart because he knew that it was no longer death that comes for us, that we have nothing to be afraid of. He showed us that it's not death but life that comes for us. So much so that here in a few moments in our prayers, we're going to say that for those saddened by the certainty of dying, indeed, Lord, the hope of immortality has come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended. That's what we profess during this Easter season, what we profess today for Anna and those who have gone before us, that life has changed, not ended. Which is precisely why we can sit here in prayer and we can know that we can continue to talk to her. We can continue to ask her for her guidance. That her motherly instinct, that as a wife, that we can still call upon her as a friend. Because life has changed. Not ended. But what that also means is one other thing that we as Catholics firmly believe is that when we pass from this side of the mortal veil and wake up on the next, we don't do so alone. Scared, standing before a vengeful God who has been like an accountant weighing our good and our bad. No, that's not what we believe. What we believe is that we are surrounded by all of our friends and our family members. Those who have gone before us. And they greet us. And they say, this is your good and faithful servant, Lord. Your beloved daughter, whom you've known since before the foundations of the world. And indeed, he gazed upon her, and he looks at us. He says, you, my daughter, my beloved, thank you. And come into the home that I prepared for you since the foundations of the world. Please stand. And as we continue to pray for Anna, I would like to invite Charlie Ford to lead us in the prayers of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
The response is, risen Lord, hear our prayer. For those who bear the cross of pain in mind or body, may they never feel forsaken by God. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Risen Lord, establish in Anna your light and presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may call Anna to happiness in the company of all the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
May God welcome into his glory those of our family and friends who have departed this life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are blessed to have known Anna, may they find peace and comfort in their sorrow. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people.
whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb, forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated as we prepare the altar.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen for the Son. You were chosen from all women, and for woman, shining one. Gentle woman, quiet morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love.
Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Anna may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he, blessed
blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel. If you're unable to kneel, please be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Francis Xavier, St. Anna, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop and his assistant bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Anna, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who has united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. As Catholics, we believe that the Eucharist truly is the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ. Here in a few moments, if you are a Catholic who is prepared to receive Holy Communion, you'll be invited to come forward in the usual way to present yourself. If you are not a Catholic who is prepared to receive Holy Communion, you're welcome to stay seated in your pew, or you are welcome to come forward. We ask you to please cross your arms across your chest, and we'll give you a blessing, and we look forward to the day when we can all share at our Lord's table. At this time, I ask you to please kneel. If you're unable to kneel, please be seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Please stand. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Anna, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Anna, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed on Anna in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and hear our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Let us sing together our closing hymn, number 795. On Eagle's Wings, number 795.
Under
faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun. Lest you dash your foot against a stone, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun.